If you have invested in China's economy by any means, such as buying index funds that track China's markets, or having a pension fund that invests in China, or directly owning stocks in any Chinese companies, then this video might give you some meaningful perspective. According to official data, the Chinese economy has been growing at a high speed. In 2010, it became the second largest in the world. But many in the media and academic circles have been questioning the authenticity of China's official GDP and its growth rate. The Chinese Communist Party is an authoritarian regime that lacks transparency in many aspects. To attract foreign investments and to prove its legitimacy to the Chinese people, the CCP has the incentive to fabricate numbers. So what exactly is GDP? It's short for gross domestic product and is essentially the value of all finished goods and services produced in a country within a period. It measures the volume of economic activities within a country. In other words, the Chinese economy might not be as big and fast-growing as many believe, and those who make investment decisions based on fabricated data could expose themselves to larger-than-expected risks. There are experts who have unveiled some truths about China's economy. How have they done it, and what does China's actual GDP data look like? Let's find out. The barometer of economy, energy consumption. All else equal, the higher amount of economic activity, the more energy would be consumed. Therefore, energy consumption data can be used as an indicator for the economy. According to its 2001 National Bureau of Statistics Yearbook, China's energy consumption dropped year by year between 1997 and 1999, coincidental with the Asian financial crisis. A BBC reporter noticed China's reportedly yearly GDP growth for the period was kept well above 7%, and clearly there was some discrepancy. The CCP might have realized this issue. Starting with the 2010 yearbook, the energy consumption for those years were adjusted to show an upward trend so that it matched with the GDP. The 2015 yearbook saw another major revision of previous year's energy consumption figures. It seems the CCP has been changing China's economic data as it wishes. As a source told BBC, quote, "It's just to make the numbers look good." But do the numbers look good in the eyes of professionals? Testing data's authenticity with Benford's Law. Benford's Law is a mathematical tool named after GE physicist Frank Benford. Essentially, it points out that in a set of naturally occurring numbers, the probability of the numbers from 0 to 9 appearing in a certain digit should follow a certain distribution pattern. For example, the first digit being 1 should occur about 30.1% of the time in a set of numbers. The law is also applicable to the second set and other digits. In many cases, it can be used to detect artificially generated data, and can be used as admissible evidence in U.S. courts. The law has been adapted to show Greece's suspected data manipulation before its debt crisis. In 2013, researchers at Australia and New Zealand Banking Group suggested in a report to have used Benford's Law to find strangeness in China's economic data. The report noted that in its quarterly GDP growth data from December 1991 to September 2012, the number 0 appeared more often in the second digit than what Benford's Law would predict. In the 1985 to 2012 inflation data, the research again found more frequent appearances of numbers 1 and 2 in the second digits than would be predicted by the law. Although the report was not direct proof, the researchers said the test raised doubt on the quality of economic data published by the CCP. But can we practically estimate the extent of data manipulation? Verification with satellite images. As previous research suggested, the amount of night light captured by satellites can be a good indicator of economic activity, and it's harder to manipulate than GDP. Luis R. Martinez is an assistant professor at the University of Chicago. In his report titled, "How Much Should We Trust the Dictator's GDP Estimates?" Martinez studied data from 1992 to 2008, and explained the method of using satellite images of a country's night light to determine the credibility of its official economic data. He created the nightlight elasticity ratio, which is a measure of a country's reported GDP growth relative to the increase in nightlight. His findings indicated the ratio is higher in more authoritarian countries, which means those countries are more likely to overstate economic growth and likely by a factor of 1.15 to 1.3. As for China, Martinez estimated, quote, "Hence, the adjustment to aggregate GDP growth for China and Myanmar corresponds to a reduction of the yearly growth rate from 6.3% to 4.9%, which implies an exaggeration bias of 29%. Martinez's method was very creative. but is it possible to come to a similar conclusion using a more direct approach? A forensic examination. The reporting mechanism of China's GDP further adds to the criticism of its credibility. In 2019, four professors from the Chinese University of Hong Kong and the University of Chicago jointly published a report titled "A Forensic Examination of China's National Accounts." The report noted that CCP officials in charge of China's provinces and cities tend to overstate their jurisdiction's GDP growth in order to advance their careers. Beijing, being aware of the practice, has been making adjustments to the local statistics to come up with the national GDP figures. As a result, the GDP of China's provinces combined is usually higher than China's total GDP. By doing forensic accounting on China's tax revenue, satellite nightlight images, electricity consumption, railway cargo shipment, exports, and imports, the researchers concluded that Beijing's adjustments to provincial GDP have been inaccurate since 2008, and that China's yearly GDP growth rate between 2008 and 2016 was estimated to be 1.8 percentage points lower than reported. Using their estimates, China's GDP growth rate of 6.7% in 2016 should be reduced to 4.9%. So has this subject caught the U.S. government's attention? USCC. China's government continues to falsify statistics. In November 2019, the U.S.-China Economic and Security Review Commission concluded in its report to Congress that Beijing continues to falsify official economic statistics for political purposes. It stated, quote, "As economic growth slows and reporting on the economy becomes increasingly politicized, officials may feel more tempted to falsify official data releases." It also recognized independent studies that concluded China's true yearly economic growth rate is estimated to be 0.5 to 3 percentage points lower than the reported 6 to 6.5%. Top CCP official doesn't believe in its data. If you believe the studies mentioned only represent those in the West who are overly critical of the Chinese government, then this might surprise you. Even the current premier of China, Li Keqiang, doesn't trust his government's numbers. In 2007, when Li was in charge of China's Liaoning province, he indicated to then U.S. Ambassador to China, Clark T. Rant Jr., that his government's GDP numbers are unreliable. Instead, Li preferred more direct indicators such as cargo volumes on railways, electricity consumption, and the total amount of new loans issued. After the conversation was leaked, The Economist created the so-called Li Keqiang Index based on its understanding of Li's criteria. All investments come with their risks, but how well investors understand the risks depends on the quality of accessible information. The Chinese Communist Party has the incentive to manipulate Chinese economic data so that investors are more likely to overestimate the return but underestimate the risks. We are not here to advise on whether to invest in China. Instead, we encourage you to do as much research as possible so that you'll make a sound decision. As Benjamin Franklin put it, quote, "An investment in knowledge pays the best interest." What's your opinion on this subject? Leave your comments below. Thank you for watching Unseen Fortunes. If you enjoyed our content, please click like, subscribe, and share. We'll see you next time.